Hey, Tim, how are you? Hey, Michael. It's Elder Tatum, how you doing? Keisa, hello. LaShawn, how are you? Thought maybe you'd be asleep. You had a long day. Elnora, how are you? Good to see you. How's everybody doing tonight? Hope you've had a great week. Sherry. Hey, Samantha. He's in. Hello, hello, hello. Hey, Durham. Hey, Demetrius, what's up, man? How's everybody doing tonight? Hey, Janice. Diana, hey. Cheryl, good to see you. Oh, thanks, man. Praise him, everybody. Good evening, one and all. And I'm doing well, thank you. Yeah, I missed you guys too in the last couple of weeks. We'll talk about that in a second. Yeah, we took a couple of weeks off. It's kind of rare that we've taken a couple of weeks off back to back, but I think part of the thing was I'm going to talk about it tonight. And when you get to this time of the year, you kind of find yourself sometimes running on empty a little bit. So instead of just forcing it, and we took a couple of Thursday nights off, but we're back and with a new series, and got some rest, thank God. And but had just a very busy little stretch there, where we were in Vegas a couple of weeks ago with Bishop Clinton House, and for their anniversary, and I was just blessed to be able to minister one of their services on that Sunday, the 29th of September. So we thank God that he has kept us. And I think that one of the things I wanted to talk about was the fact that when we get to this time of the year, I don't know, maybe I'll just ask this question. Maybe it's just me. I don't think it is, but maybe it's just me. Hey, Elder Cowan. Hey, Robert Sanders. Good to see you. But I think that if you're, you know, like me, in the same boat that I'm in, it seems that at this time of the year, we're in the fourth quarter of the year, the last fourth quarter of the decade, and two things I want to mention. One is that we have to finish strong, and even while we're finishing strong, we're actually preparing and really strategizing for 2020. Which is months away now. And so you can't wait till you're in the season to prepare for the season. I'm looking at my beloved Los Angeles Lakers and all the teams in the NBA that are preparing. They are ready now. But of course, they didn't start getting ready a couple of weeks ago when training camp started. They were already preparing in the off season. Matter of fact, way back as far as even maybe May and June, they were already starting to work out. They were already starting to get themselves ready. And so I've always been a real proponent, especially over the last several years, even with, here at Spirit and Life, of trying to encourage people to start preparing for the next season, the next year, somewhere around September of the current year that you're in. Because you can't be, you know, hit the ground running in January. You have to be already making progress. You have to already be ready to implement plans and already moving forward. And so, but even as you look at it as the last quarter of the year, it's just like in an athletic competition, in games, you have to understand that the fourth quarter is the time where now games are won and lost. And there's some things that we're going to have to understand about what the Lord had promised us in 2019. The year is not over yet, and so we still have an opportunity to receive what God has promised us. The other point I want to make was that usually around this time of the year, you start to realize that there's some things that may not have come to pass. Sherry is saying, reflect on the year. There's some things that you may not have accomplished. There were some things that you saw coming, the things that the Lord had promised you, that just seems like they haven't come to pass. They haven't happened yet. And then it seems like the closer you get to the promise, the closer you get to what God has for you, the more the enemy intensifies his attack. That's what I want to talk about too. I want you to understand how things work. Many times the enemy is strategic in what he does. He's intentional in what he does. And so what happens is, the closer you get to that breakthrough, the closer you get to reaching what God has for you, it seems like stuff starts happening out of nowhere. We've had a couple of things. Even as we were in Vegas, was really a weekend of celebration. In fact, it was my pastoral anniversary that weekend. As a matter of fact, Bishop House and I had the same day of pastoral anniversary. But we had a couple of incidents that happened over that weekend, just in a matter of, it seemed like hours, things that that came to pass. Matter of fact, something even happened overnight from Saturday night going into Sunday. I've got to get up and preach the 8 o'clock service, and there's a, you know, I'm looking at a text from my daughter, and there was a lot of stuff going on back at home. And it was just one of those things where you realize the enemy is going to start throwing things at us that to get us off track. Then if it's not you going through it, it's somebody connected to you. There are people connected to you. There are people in ministry, people here in my church that are going through some really horrific things that are just seemingly coming all at once. Everybody's got some major issue. I don't know. I don't see no thumbs up. Maybe I'm alone. Maybe it's just a few of us out here. But I'm telling you, this seems like there are some things that come out of nowhere. There are things the enemy tries to throw at you at the last minute and let you, and to try to get you to react. There, oh, I see some thumbs. All right, so I'm not alone. Thank God. But what happens is, as you're getting closer, the enemy knows that if you continue to move forward, if you continue to operate in faith, if you continue to believe God, and you're going to reach those goals. And sometimes, because it hasn't happened yet, the enemy likes to let our minds start to wander, and we start wondering and saying, well, maybe we start getting really antsy and anxious about trying to figure out, okay, how can I make this happen, and how can I accelerate the process? Or I'm really close, and it seems like as soon as you get closest, it's like, you know, Charlie Brown and Lucy, the old cartoon where, you know, he gets ready to kick the football and she pulls it away from him. Anybody experienced that in the last month or so, where all of a sudden something that you thought was right there seemed like it just didn't materialize. It didn't come to pass. And so the enemy starts playing with your mind now. And now you're starting to figure out, okay, maybe I missed the mind of God, or maybe there's something else I need to do. And instead of just operating in faith, instead of just waiting and being patient, we start to panic a little bit. And see, then that pressure starts to wear on us. And today, I believe, is Mental Health Day. And that's where a lot of us are really coming up short. We're feeling pressure. We're feeling anxious. We're having things come at us from all sides. And there are times, and I don't know if you've ever had these moments, where you're sitting there in your living room, or sitting on the edge of your bed, or sometimes sitting in your car, just sitting in your driveway, and wondering what in the world is going on. It seems like stuff is falling apart all around me. And you're saying, I thought this was going to be my year. I thought this was going to be my time. I thought I claimed this season. I decreed and declared some things over my life, and I know that the Lord told it to me, but now here things are falling apart. Relationships get silly. All of a sudden now, there's some physical things that are going on. There's some emotional things that are happening. There's some mental things that are happening. And you're saying to yourself, then all of a sudden the money, then right when you thought everything was cool, then now your money got funny. And now you're getting, you know, and so now you're saying, what am I going to do? And so he's increasing his pressure. The enemy is increasing the pressure. And he's trying to get you distracted and get us to lose focus and get us to lose hope. And I know we don't like to talk about that very much, but there are times where even the very people of God, the people that I'm talking to you, are, you know, you believe God, but then there's some unbelief that creeps in. Then you start wondering whether you missed the mind of God. And then you start getting upset. Because then you start comparing yourself to others, and you're looking at what their, you know, their highlight reel that they put on social media, and you start to say, well, maybe it's just me. No, all of us are struggling. All of us are going through some stuff. All of us are having, we have these great moments, and then as you look over the year, you say, I thought this was going to happen this year. But listen, I want to give you a little heads up. It's like I want to huddle up with you for a moment tonight. We got some other lessons we're going to talk about during the series, but tonight I want to just kind of pull you over to the side like good coaches do in the NBA. First thing the coaches do, I said it on Sunday in the message, but the first thing the coaches do when they come to the end of the quarter, the coaches walk out to the middle of the floor themselves and they huddle up and they begin to strategize about what we're going to take to the team. The team, in the meantime, is sitting there resting, recovering, refreshing themselves, and toweling off, getting ready to go back out there and compete. I want to encourage you tonight that the Lord has a strategy already in place. There's some ways we're going to attack. Yeah, the enemy may have gotten up by a few points. Maybe he's leading right now. They may have the momentum, but the Lord is about to swing the momentum back in our favor because victory has been ordained by God. The Lord has ordained our victory. Our victory is certain. Oh, come on. Let me hear. I don't know. I got some thumbs coming on that. But your victory is certain. I don't care what news you've received. I don't care what has happened. I don't care what the most recent news you've gotten, the most recent disappointment that has occurred. The Lord says your victory has already been ordained. Thanks be to God that giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. It's going to be a question of faith now. Amen. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. What has happened is the things that have occurred are starting to get us where our faith is starting to waver a little bit. Our faith is getting a little shaky. Our hope is starting to diminish. But the Lord says, no, we're huddling up right now. And it's going to be on us as ministers, as pastors, as leaders. We're going to come back and we're going to huddle up and just tell you, listen, we're going to win this game. We're going to win this game in this fourth quarter. Hallelujah. We're going to win in the fourth quarter. We're going to come back. Amen. The Lord is always a God of the second half. Amen. Sometimes it seems like the enemy is winning. He's getting out in a big lead. But the Lord is the Lord of the second half, and he always knows how to bring us back at the last minute. So don't worry. You've got four, you know, we're in the fourth quarter. But don't worry. We're in the 10th month. The 10th month. 10 is a divine number. Hallelujah. 10 is a number of divinity and order. So God is setting some things in order for each and every one of us. So what we have to do right now is sit down, calm down. Amen. Take a deep breath, get your strength back, and then we got to focus. We got to get our focus back to now listen. What did the Lord tell you? Remember what he told you when he had the game plan at the beginning of 2019. What was the original game plan? How are we going to attack? What was our goal? What were we trying to accomplish? The Lord is saying very clearly, the things that he put in your spirit, he put them in there for a reason. And I'm preaching like the Lakers already won. It's in my spirit. It's already the championship is ours. I see us in the parade in June. But anyway, but watch what happens. You've got to understand this about God, that he is going to download the things into you. That's why we got to get back to our basics, our quiet time, our time of prayer and reflection, Amen. We got to get back to, amen, reading the Word of God daily and sometimes multiple times a day, praying multiple times a day, but prayer and fasting, and but seeking God's face. We have to cut off the noise. We have to cut out the distractions. We got to quit listening to everything. We got to quit allowing everything in our spirits. But first of all, you got to believe that victory is yours. We have to believe that it is ours. You will not lose. I wish I had some folks that would write that on there. I will not lose. I'm not losing. I'm not going to lose in 2019. Everything God promised me is coming to pass. It's going to happen. And it's not, we're not going to put it off and say, well, okay, maybe next year. No, listen, this year is not over. Let's go and get it. Amen. I saw Elder Carrie Turner the other night. Did a video, and she said that she's going to still, she's looking at, we're going to get what God told us in 2019. She said, I'm putting a demand on 2019. I'm not waiting till next year. That's what we do all the time. We push it to the side. Say, oh, well, must not have been. Listen, we're going to get it now in the name of Jesus. I'm going to talk about this in maybe next week, but the children of Israel, when they had sent the spies over in the book of Numbers, amen, Joshua and Caleb came back with another report. They, you know, folks were mystified by the giants. And some of you are tripping right now because there's giants that seem like have come up out of nowhere. The land is good. The promise is right there. But the giants are right here. And it seemed like we can't defeat them. And they had the folks' hearts melted. Joshua and Caleb stilled the people. And that's what I want to do tonight. I want to still you. I want to calm you down. Relax. Let's go up and get it right now. Let's go get it at once. He said, if the Lord delights in us, he'll give us the good of the land. We can win. If the Lord wants us to, we're going to win. And guess what? I just got news for you. God wants you to win. In fact, he's already ordained your victory. He's already ordained that you will be the winner when it's all said and done. So let's be encouraged. Let's get our breath. Now let's go get it. Amen. Don't give up on the dream. Don't give up on the thing. God bless you, Elder Pollard. Don't give up on the strategy that God outlined to you. Amen. Make sure you're staying in your lane and focusing because God said this is your time. So don't think, okay, 2019 is not my year. Oh, yes, it is. If you said it back in January, you got to believe it here in October. Amen. You got to understand that it can be your year just like that. Everything can change just like that. And you got to be determined. I will not lose. I'm going to get everything the Lord promised me in 2019 and some. Because that's how the Lord does. He always gives you more anyway. So don't underestimate the power of God that is in your life. Don't underestimate God's hand resting on you. He is ordaining your victory. So I want to encourage you tonight. Don't sit back and say and throw in the towel. Don't check out of the game. Don't say, well, you know what? It's okay. I'm going to wait till January. No, the new year has already started. We already operating in 2020. Let's go. Let's go get it. I tell people all the time, sometimes when folks call and they're upset and they're, you know, you know, going through it, I say, all right, now what you're going to do right now, I want you to get up. I want you to go wash your face. All right. Towel, dry off, take a deep breath or two and come back out here. Let's go get it. That's all we have to do. There are times where you're going to have to, you know, focus. And when I'm hearing all this crazy news, I'm thinking, okay, now I got to go preach to 1,000 people or so at Bishop House's church. Amen. God bless you, Angela Winbush. Good to see you, my sister. She was with me that weekend. And so, but again, when you understand there are things that happen, but you got to remain focused on the task at hand. Remember, make it simple, everybody. Make it simple. Make sure you understand this is what we're going to do. The best coaches in football, basketball, they know how to just get the players to focus. Listen, okay, this is what we got to do. This is October 10th. So let's remember what God told you. Drag out those notes. Drag out those things he told you. Remember, bring those notes back to your memory. And now listen, this is how we're going to attack. We're going to get back in the Word of God. We're going to get back to attending church. Amen. We're going to get back to praising and worshiping God. And we're going to also, not only are we going to pray, but we're going to listen for the next instruction. Make sure we pay attention. We're going to stay in our lane. We're not going to trip off of people. We're going to keep pushing. If folks are with us, cool. If they're not, let's keep moving. We don't have time. We'll see you later. Just go get what God has for you. So understand this very clearly. I'm going to leave you with this thought. God has ordained our victory. Amen. He's ordained your victory. So let's go get it. Let's go do what God has called us to do. Let's become who God has called us to become. Because 2020, we're not waiting till January. It starts tonight. It starts right now. How you prepare in the next few months is going to dictate how well you go in the next season. Amen. You've got to prepare in it now. One of my members, Anthony Boyer, was played in the NBA, and he was talking about how he said you started preparing for what you were going to do way before training camp. By the time training camp rolled around, you were already semi in shape. Amen. And you start thinking this is what's going to happen next. Part of our problem as people of God, I got to let you go, is that we don't sit down and think things through. We have to learn how to think and get the mind of God for whatever is about to happen in our lives. The Lord's already in our future, so he already knows it. But understand this, we have to get to the point where we realize that what God has for us is ours. The victory is ours, and we've got to move into it with a clear mind. In the name of Jesus. God bless you all. I love you all. I'm so glad to be back. As you can see, I got a lot of energy now. But anyway, but we're going to be going through. We're going to have this new series starting. And I want to encourage you to check us out every week. Invite some friends. Matter of fact, share this particular live stream. Share this with somebody on your timeline. Make sure that folks that are around you, people that are connected to you, it's going to be important too that people that are connected to you have the victory or know they have the victory too, all right? Because if they don't understand who they are, they'll start becoming a hindrance to you becoming who you're supposed to be. They'll be hindering you from getting where you are supposed to go. So make sure that folks that are connected to you are going in the same direction you're going, all right? Amen. God bless you all. I love you all. I thank God for all of you tuning in tonight. I missed you for a couple of weeks, but I'm back, and Lord willing, we'll be back in stride every week. And of course, later this month, at the end of this month, matter of fact, in October 31st through November 2nd, I will be in Atlanta, Georgia. So we might have to do a Facebook Live from there. But and I'll be in Atlanta, Georgia at the You Can Get There From Here Leadership Conference, Bishop Mark Moore. I'm excited. I'm going to be doing a seminar dealing with how to develop mature disciples, taken from, there it is, for mature audiences only. I don't know if you have your copy yet. If you don't, you need to get your copy of For Mature Audiences Only. And then I'm also going to be doing a series. You can go to stevehamiltonministries.com and pick up your copy. I'm going to be doing a session with my friend, Apostle Timothy Finley Jr. from Louisville, Kentucky. We're going to be doing a conference, a session at the conference entitled How to Deal with a Toxic Church Culture. Amen. Dealing with toxic people. So I'm looking forward to that. So that's October 31st through November 2nd. Thank you, Pastor April, for putting that up. ExploreYCGT.com. You can register today. Go register. I'd love to see you in Atlanta. We're going to have some books down there too. So, you know, I'll be there signing books and all that good stuff. So if you'd like to get a copy of this though, you can get a copy now. You can get a copy, you know, it'll be with you in a couple of days. You can get your copy. I will sign it for you. There are lots of different sources you can get it from. You can get it. Thank you, April. See, look at get your book at stevehamiltonministries.com. There you go. You love your book, and those of you that have read it and hopefully you enjoyed it and you were blessed. Let me know. You can slip me a message and let me know what stood out to you and what blessed you. Angela Winbush is one of the wonderful people that did a review of it. for me. She did a marvelous job, and so she's in the book, and so also Bishop House, and, amen. Also Bishop R.C. Blakes, my friend, is in there, and Chandrella Avery is in there, and then most of all, Bishop Noel Jones was kind enough to do the foreword for our book. So anyway, God bless you all. Hope you have a great rest of your week. Stay in prayer. Remember, you got the victory, though. And Lord willing, get to somebody's church on Sunday. If you can't get there in person, go online and stream a service, because you need a word this weekend. Amen. God bless you. I love you. I'm praying for you. Please share this with somebody else and let them be blessed as well. God bless you. We will see you, Lord willing, next Thursday night at 8:30 p.m. Love you all. God bless you. Bye-bye.